OU was one of the most fun times of my life. You know, I'd like to say it was the most edifying but it was actually a whole lot of fun. I think the president's leadership class that we were in was one of the things that kind of introduced me to the whole campus and who's who at the zoo. And I was in a fraternity at Sigma Alpha Epsilon. I had a great time with the brothers there. Yeah. It was a great time. We had five members of my family on campus at the same time. And so we ran everybody for the Senate. And at that time, the Senate only had 40 people. So we were kidding that if we would invite dates from the Senate, that we could go ahead and, you know, hold quorum and pass anything we wanted. And I think we wrote so that nepotism would not arise like that again. For the all-campus sing, I led the Sig Alphs, and I can't remember if it was the Kappas or the Chios, and we disqualified ourselves right off the bat, and where everybody was supposed to dress up in pastel colors and sing Climb Every Mountain, this is many years ago, we chose to do the Jefferson and Starship version of Volunteers of America. So we had strobe lights going, we had flags waving, we had long hair flying and bell bottoms, which at the time, you know, there was like all kinds of restrictions, but we brought the house down, so we had a great time.
John is distinguished, and he has no field. And what I've always said about John is boxes don't apply to John.
That I'm trying to encapsulate a lot of what I've done into a little book, a children's book, called Otter Redwater. Being able to put it together as an inspiration to not only Native American kids, but kids around the world about how to pull together a team, a posse, a crew, and be able to fulfill your dream, helping others to fulfill their dream, and be able to climb a mountain. And I think that book has been probably, which is being manifested now, is probably my passion. What I do generally is public-private partnerships, working with companies. And now that universities are more involved with some of those collaborations towards bringing green energy back in, that's a thrill. And being a Choctaw, I'm able to help identify green technologies. Otter Redwater will help bring, as a kid and an icon, be able to bring green technologies back into tribal lands, be able to bring that forth so that we can build a sustainable future. Because right now we're just running on fumes. If you can begin to identify your dream and then what the impact of that dream will be on the rest of the world, your immediate world around you, and as those ripples go throughout the world, what impact would that have? Because there's a whole lot of people who've left unexamined lives and unfulfilled lives with desperate frustration. But there's an opportunity now. We can do anything. It's amazing.